peace to the gods and the goddesses. This is Brother Sakim. I've been away for a while because of the pandemic, so I haven't been down to Philadelphia doing anything. And see, reason why, I just want to say something real quick, right? Haven't been no Hebrews down here either. Right down the street where the Hebrews usually be. I'm going to tell you the difference between us and between the Hebrews. See, we go on basic reality. See, we don't have somebody in the sky that's supposed to be backing us up. That's supposed to be all powerful and almighty. But yet,
that never show up.
And all of a sudden, when the coronavirus shows up, everybody disappears. So it's like they your mind kids, the synagogues and your churches, the same way it treated the football stadiums, the banks, the coffee store, the bus terminal, and all the other shit that's out here, treated it the same way. You couldn't gather because the coronavirus is gonna like kill everybody in the place. So I'm just wondering, do you have more faith in your God, or do you have more faith in the coronavirus killing your ass? So I'm gonna get this over to my brother PEMPAMSIE real quick, and he just gonna go in on a couple things, you know, and stage is yours.
Peace, peace. Peace and black power, as much power we can get. But well, let me introduce myself. My name is Brother PEMPAMSIE. You can find me at my YouTube page, Brother PEMPAMSIE. Really, man, going off what the brother said, me, myself, I believe in the Creator. I believe in the Creator. But that Creator has already done his job as far as I'm concerned. He gave us life. He gave us a place to live. He gave us the elements to breathe. He put everything in our bodies that we need to sustain ourselves. So the Creator job is done. So when I'm asking for stuff, I'm asking myself. I'm not pointing up in the sky. I'm not blaming somebody that's under the ground. You know, any evil that I do or good that I've done that. And I know what I was doing when I was doing it. I don't blame it on nobody else. It's all me. Again, like my brother Sakim was saying, the coronavirus should open your eyes right now. It should really open your eyes. Ain't nothing coming to save you. Ain't nobody coming to save you. Now let me say this. Jesus might come to save you. Jesus.
Y'all can have it.
But any black person talking about some white dude coming to save him, I feel as though you're a fool. You want the white Jesus to come and save you from what his put you in. No, that don't make no sense to me. I'm gonna save myself. As simple as that. And that's what everybody else gonna have to do. That's what all y'all gonna have to do. Y'all gonna have to save yourself. Stop waiting for somebody to come and save you. Do it yourself. I mean, I don't even know what to say sometimes. Like because I've been going through this with my people for so long. It's like I run out of words because we are so indoctrinated that you're afraid to even read something different. You're afraid to even look into something different. Your mind has been so indoctrinated that you won't even listen to nothing else. And it hurts real bad. It just hurts my heart when I talk to people, when I listen to the craziness that come out their mouth, and then they're going to tell me I'm crazy. Then they're going to tell me I'm crazy because I don't believe in nobody up in the sky. So I'm crazy. I'm the crazy one. But you seeing and talking is something that you can't see or hear. But I'm the crazy one, though, huh? Sure. And to my Muslim brothers, y'all still my brothers? I ain't got no beef with no Muslim. But you talking the same thing. It's the same thing. It's all Abrahamic religions. It's the same thing. You just giving it a different name. You doing the same thing, bro. I mean, really, I don't even want to go into it with my Muslim brothers because I got a lot of friends that's Muslim, and I was at one point. And I don't want to have no animosity, especially with people that I grew up with. It's still running though. It just get dark. But yeah, I don't want to have no animosity with no brother that I came up with, my family members, because most of my family is either Christian or Muslim. So I don't want to have no animosity with nobody. I'm just not rocking with that. And I don't want to hear it either. You know? If you want to believe what you want to believe, you stay over there. Don't bring it to me, because if you bring it to me, I got something to say about it, and I'm not going to hold my tongue. So that's why I say I don't like to really go in like I want to, because, like I said, all my family, everybody in my family got some type of belief. So, and as I look around down here, we downtown Philadelphia, and I look around, and I guarantee I can take 10 random people right now. There's 10 random people, just stop them. And somebody gonna tell me they were Christian or Muslim. And you gotta understand, nobody is born, yeah, let me go here. Nobody is born with a book. Nobody is born, words from my brother Seti, no one is born with a book strapped to your ass. So you are taught these things, but you taught by people that's in your household. So if you grew up in a Muslim household, of course you're going to be Muslim. If you grew up in a Christian household, of course you're going to be Christian. But see, the Hebrews ain't nothing but Christians to me, too. So I just want
gangster Christian.
So of course you're gonna absorb what you taught, but just remember, another human being taught you that. The one that they teaching you about didn't teach you that. You was talking to the middleman. You're talking to the middleman. When is the king, the almighty, the sustainer? When is that person gonna talk to everybody? When? And let me say this. Everybody always says that he talks to him. But why he only talk to one person at a time? Why can't he just talk to a group of people at one time? A group. That's why I don't believe none of that shit that people tell me. You just hearing shit in your head. You hearing voices in your head is your own voice. Ain't nobody talking to you in your head. You think the creator of the universe, the creator of this earth, got time to talk to you? To a mere mortal? This almighty being got time to talk to you. After he gave you life, after he gave you a place to live, now you want more. I feel as though you're being a little greedy when you're praying for stuff. You want more. You want more, okay, understand this. If you believe that your God is perfect and the plan that he made for you is perfect, what are you praying for? Because you're praying for more than what he already gave you. So evidently you don't believe that his plan is that great. because you wouldn't pray for nothing. You would just accept whatever happened to you because you said this was ordained for you. But yet, again, we're going to have some people. You know, I would say something about my foot. When I, let me stop. But yeah, still, you're going to have certain people and certain black people going to see this post and say, look at this dude, he's insane. And guess what? If I am insane, I'll gladly accept it. You see, let me tell you why I deal with Kemet. Let me tell you why I practice Kemetic spirituality. Because not yet has it lied to me. Hasn't lied to me yet. Yes, we got a book just like y'all have a book. But guess who wrote our book, and guess who will tell you that they wrote our book? Our ancestors. And they ain't going to tell you that somebody talked to them in their head and they was inspired by a God or however you want to call them to write the book. They wrote the book through observation of Shu and Tefnut and Geb and Nut. You understand? Nature's. They haven't lied to me yet. You see my own, my flag in my way. You hold my flag for me, brother. You see, my unk represents the wound of the woman. Penis of the man, out comes the children. This is the key of life, okay? I walk around with life on my chest, okay? But when you put that cross on, you walk around with death on your chest because it represents death, okay? What's in the graveyards? Crosses. You won't see no onk in no graveyard. Okay? The eye of Haru. Not the eye of Horus, Haru, the all-seeing eye. You understand? My name and Dinkra symbol right here, Brother PEMPAMSIE. This is the PEMPAMSIE and Dinkra symbol, meaning steadfastness. You see? And I had a brother ask me, well, so do you pray to your onk? Do your onk give you certain type of powers? No, my onk don't give me certain type of powers. No, my onk don't do nothing for me but symbolize life. That's what it does. Okay, I can't take my onk off and make electric come somewhere or make something levitate. No, it's symbolism. I got away from the mic, I'm sorry. It's symbolism. It's nothing magical about what I got on. It's a representation. And again, like I said, my spirituality system has not lied to me about nothing. Okay? About anything. Even when people see, like when they see on the hieroglyphics, well, I call it hieroglyphics, but that's a European name. It's the metanetia that's on the walls. And they see a picture of Nut and Geb with the penis out, right? I wish I could bring this picture up, but they see the picture, and a lot of people want to say that it's gay. Well, first of all, man, I thought being gay that you had to have sex with another of the same race. This is a picture of Geb, which is the earth, and Nut, which is the sky. And that's a woman. So I don't see nothing gay about it. And second of all, the picture is just a symbolism. Geb is the earth, Nut is the sky. So how can it be gay? That thing was kind of loud. So, kind of it. But yeah, how can it be gay? So again, Kemet has not lied to me yet. Okay? We dig up the bodies all over. I'm going to say Egypt because I know a lot of y'all don't know the name Kemet. So I'm going to use Egypt for a little bit. But you'll find our kings, and I had to say it in the correct way, I Nesut Bidu. You'll find them. We found bodies. We got bodies of the people who constructed the pyramids, Imhotep. Well, I'm not saying that we found Imhotep, so let me take that back. But we found some of the kings. Where the bodies at anybody in the Bible? Well, there they are. Give me some proof. I have proof. Any religion, give me any type of proof. Any type of proof. That's all I'm asking. Because I'm not going to just take your word for anything. I'm not going to take your word for it. And then, I had somebody say, well, how do you know that those the kings are those the kings? What do you mean? When the last time somebody got mummified? When the last time somebody, who else was doing mummification? You understand? You find the relics and everything that's why we call it, well, they call it the Book of the Dead, but it's called the personal book. You find the books next to them. But they say, well, why the books didn't deteriorate? Because they wasn't made with paper. That type of paper. Like I can answer any question anybody asks, but when I ask questions about journalism, you just tell me to go to the book. There's somebody else. Lied to me yet. Kimmy hasn't let me down yet. And for the rest of my days, I'm going to be a Kemetic practitioner. I want to be a part of the Ramesh. That's what they called them in ancient times also. So you can go ahead and read your book and talk to your unseen people. You go ahead and have fun with that, because you've been having fun with it for a long time now, for well over 2,000 years. This right here, Kemet, been around for over 5,000 years. Okay? I even want to say that's where you got most of your religions from. You got most of your religions from Kemet. Because I can go in on some things. I shouldn't even have said that, because now I should go in on some things. You know what I'm saying? But yes, there's a lot of similarities. There's a lot of similarities to your religions, to what's on them, what's on them walls. There's a lot of similarities. And if one is 2,000 and less, and this one over here is 5,000, I mean, come on. It's just, or I guess that's just a coincidence, huh? It's just a coincidence that this 5,000-year-old writing, well, let me say this, this 2,000-year-old writing, you find it in this 5,000-year-old writing, but it's just a coincidence. Show you right. See me? If I tell Brother Sakim, right? Let's say Brother Sakim. Rest my case. So, again, this is your brother PEMPAMSIE.